शंकरणालयम् नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतं वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहना भवतु, सहनौ भुनक्तु, सह वीर्यं करवावहै, तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विधाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशमुमुक्षुरुहि शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो। यं सुकं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपाधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दुर्गत्वनिर्मापारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेव अहन्नमत्वन्यदिति मे निश्चितामितिः। I think we finished the Swapna. Where was this? 283, I think. Yeah. We did the Swapna Avastha Vivechanam, I think. Yeah, Swapna Avastha Vivekaha. Then Shushupti Avastha Vivekaha. Yasyam Kevalam Sukham Ajnanam Cha Anubhuyate Sa Shushuptihi. This is a pretty well thought and quite an accurate definition of Sushupti. So now nobody can object to Sushupti not being Ananda Swarupa, or you don't have Ananda in Sushupti, because the definition of Sushupti is that avastha where you have Ajnana and Ananda. So if there is an argument that no, I do not have Ananda in Sushupti, then we can say that okay, you have not, you are not talking about Sushupti Avastha at all, because the definition of Sushupti Avastha is what? Yasyam Avasthayam Kevalam Sukham Ajnanam Cha Anubhuyate Sa Sushupti. Did you sleep and have Anubhava of not knowing anything? Yes. If someone says yes, but I did not have Sukha, then that is not Sushupti. You are awake. We don't have any arguments. You are awake maybe. You had Ajnana, but it was some state where you were not having Sukha Anubhava. If that is your argument, okay, you did not have Sushupti Anubhava at all. And this is basically just to argue. Our Shastra as well as Anubhava says that Sushupti, in Sushupti there is Ananda. Now the question is whether you attribute it to Sushupti or some other state. We resolved that yesterday as to, if I trust myself with any analysis in any state, if I can know as to what is the source of something, if I can make out that the source of sound is this particular direction or this particular distance also I can make out, that is because my indriya functioning, I trust my indriyas. I trust my antakkarana to decide as to what is the emotion. I cannot force my antakkarana to say that there is anubhava of sukha when there is anubhava of dukkha. So if I can trust my analysis in the waking, if I can trust my analysis of recollection of the dream also, not only of yesteryears, maybe I may not get the time right, but then we are not talking about discrepancies, not exceptions. We are talking about general rule. In general rule, when you make up a rule, exceptions prove the rule, but then the general rule is that in a healthy person, this is like anything, you know, anything that is sold to you also, anything, if take some medication for example, they say that this is going to cure you of these kind of symptoms. Generally, on some it may not work, there are side effects, etc., all that is possible. You are wanting to buy a vehicle, you ask what is the mileage. So this is the mileage. Generally, what is the ideal conditions? That is even far-fetched. But generally, you take an opinion of some three people you know, they are using that particular vehicle. You ask them, this is the mileage. Okay, you agree that that's the mileage because you've got a general feedback. Some gets an exceptional mileage of, you know, 10% higher, 20% lesser. You don't care. So if some people are unable to understand this Sushupti as having Ananda, in fact, many have difficulty to accept Swarupa being Ananda. in Sushupti there was Ananda is not really an objection by many. But many are not convinced that it is my Swarupa Ananda. How can I be Sukhaswarupa and still have Dukkha? And there is an issue there. If you accept that you are Sukhaswarupa, the problem of a person who says that I am Sukhaswarupa, he or she has absolutely no life left after that. To be really blunt, has no Laukika life left after that, because entire pursuit of Laukika is for Ananda. When you know that you are Ananda Swarupa, all your pursuits should drop then and there. And that is not acceptable to anyone. Masses again. It is not acceptable because I have duties to take care of. So this will all come up as to Kartavyata Buddhi, which is all right. As long as Kartavyata Buddhi is there, so long this Ananda Swarupa will also not settle down. But generally, we don't have an issue to accept whatever we trust our analysis. We don't have issue to accept as to the memory functioning in a particular manner. As we age, we may not trust it. But then generally we say that, no, I know. Why? Because I am able to recollect. I had Anubhava. I know. Nobody can counter my Anubhava. One can say there was a Bhranti. But for Bhranti to be established, something has to be proven. Nothing is available as proof to show that this Sukha is from any other source. This Sukha has to be the Atma, because there is nothing else in that Avastha. And Sukha definitely is there. It is not a Bhranti of recollecting some Sukha of some other state or some other day. It is that very night that I slept and woke up, I recollect my Ananda. I feel fresh. So my Indriyas are relaxed. All this is logically establishable. So there cannot be an argument. If you dig in further also, you are using pure logic, the Sushupti Ananda works. But still, if someone argues, I am not convinced. For that person, Shastra recommends yoga process. You cannot set aside yoga. Pure Vedanta has not worked. Pure Tarka has definitely not worked. What one has to do is, pure Tarka cannot lead to any goal, we have seen. Because there is Nana Anta possible. One logic can be countered by another. It's like a lawyer's argument. Whatever has more weightage, that wins. It has nothing to do with truth. The truth is unchallengeable. But still, one lawyer can argue one way, the other can argue another way. Whatever can be traced back to the book of law, books of law, to the rules, that lawyer wins. And this does not mean that it traces to the book of law accurately. Somehow, by hook or crook, if you can land there, then it works. And this is what Tarkikas do. Tarkikas, by hook or crook, they land on one particular area rules, where other rules may be contradictory, if you don't have a whole picture. So if Tarka has not worked, Shruti, Shraddha is lacking, one cannot completely give up one's Buddhi. One says, no, my Buddhi does not argue. How can I accept with Shraddha? I do have Shraddha, but that Shraddha is definitely lacking because Buddhi is taking priority. And this kashaya is there. There is a lot of karma backing. Karma yoga is not complete. Karma yoga not being complete, nishtha is impossible. Manana will be troublesome. Shravana will not fructify itself. Shraddha will not be complete. That time, at least yoga you follow, because there is drishta phala immediately. There is pain involved, but one has to have samadhi anubhava. This is where Tattva Bodha or any grantha, even at the most basic level, talks about the Anvaya Vetireka, where Sushupti does not have a counter. Here it is said in the earlier two, we saw that tat sakshibhuta tu atma sarvasu api avasthasu anuvartamanatvat satya swarupa. This is the Anvaya of the Atma. Then what is this Jagrat Avastha also? इयं जागृत अवस्था स्वप्न सुषुप्ति अवस्थयोः व्यभिचरति. So we say vyabhichara, looking at the states. Now this may also not be convincing for many. Jagrat avastha is not there. It is different. So jagrat avastha is different from swapna and sushupti. Meaning what you have in jagrat avastha, you do not have in swapna and sushupti. Similarly, swapna avastha. Here you see jagrat sushupti avasthayo iyam swapna avastha na bhavati. In the jagrat and sushupti avastha, there is no swapna. And then what about sushupti? We'll see that na jagrat swapna avasthayoho sushupti avastha asti. In the jagrat and swapna avastha, you don't have sushupti. Meaning there is vyabhichara of each state by comparing with the other two states. Now, another vyabhichara we looked at is that the stula sharira is there in jagrat avastha. Stula sharira is not there in the swapna and Sushupti avastha. Sukshma sharira is there in jagrat avastha and swapna avastha. It is not there in sushupti avastha. Because without the sukshma sharira, jagrat avastha, abhimani cannot function. There is no jagrat avastha interaction possible because every karma is preceded by a thought, preceded by some thinking, some justification, some emotion backing, some raga dvesha being there in the antakkarana. There is some calculation which has been done for one to act out in this stula prapancha. But still, it is more manifest here because in jagrat avastha, there are more variables, more noise to mask the sukshma sharira analysis. Therefore, analysis will be in the jagrat avastha only. But still, to recollect the, to make calculations on the sukshma sharira, to understand the sukshma sharira pure, we have to go to swapna avastha where there is no jagrat avastha noise. There is no stula sharira manifest there. The same stula sharira isn't there in swapna. The stula sharira in swapna is also sukshma. Therefore, there is no stula sharira in swapna avastha. But vice versa isn't true. Sukshma sharira is there in both these states. Now in sushupti avastha, the stula sharira and sukshma sharira is missing, only karana sharira is manifest. Missing in the sense it is all resolved. We don't say destroyed. What do we say? We say laya, mano laya, natu mano nasha. If you say mano nasha also, we don't have an issue because nasha is nasha adarshani. Dhatu artha is adarshana. There is no darshana of sukshma and stula sharira in the sushupti avastha. However, in the sushupti avastha, if you want to counter the sushupti avastha and go to that atma where there is no karana sharira, ajnana isn't there, how do you go? Sukshma sharira is there in swapna avastha but is not there in sushupti, so we have vyabhichara very clearly. How do you show the karana sharira vyabhichara? It is only possible in mukti, or a sampling is given in samadhi avastha. Therefore, jagrat avastha has stula sharira which has vyabhichara in the other two states. Swapna avastha has sukshma sharira which has vyabhichara in one state, sushupti. And sushupti avastha has karana sharira where there is no third state to have vyabhichara. For this reason, there is difficulty of ananda mimamsa. And if that is so, if it is not convincing, if the sushupti avastha showing one's ananda swarupa or the ananda anubhava not being there in sushupti, these are the doubts, then there is no other way out but to have samadhi anubhava. Samadhi, which was so far in Vedanta optional, becomes mandatory for this person. Because this person is a kind of person who will say, if I don't have anubhava of this, I don't accept it. Shraddha is there, all right. But then there is more overpowering buddhi, there is more overpowering dependency on something else, which is outside the shastras, which is actually outside the anubhava also. The buddhi is troubling the acceptance of the anubhava as the anubhava of that particular kala. Scientifically inconclusive as well. There are so many areas in science inconclusive. So you need more experimentation. So Shastra suggests Samadhi for that very reason. Vedanta Shastra, not any other Shastra. Vedanta Shastra also talks about samadhi. We have seen through and through. Entire Gita, sixth chapter is samadhi yoga. It is not some other, turiya avastha acceptance. Bhagavan Krishna is talking about samadhi. And those who attended Gita Patha, they know that we have seen the Gudartha Deepika, which is an elaboration of this samadhi and comparison with the Vedanta Prakriya as well. And where the conclusion is, both lead to the same goal with jnana preceding. That is the thing that doesn't vary. Jnana is definitely needed, jnanena moksha, but yoga samadhi helps one to resolve all doubts, which one may not be able to explain to others also. That very person who was so logical, if he has samadhi anubhava, then that sushupti ananda, he does not need. What is the idea there? What the only idea, the only take home is ananda being one's own swarupa. Anyway, so moving on, yasyam kevalam sukham ajnanam cha anubhuyate sa sushuptihi. Since ajnana also is there, kevalam sukham. There is kevala sukham is not vishaya janya. There is no vishaya there. You cannot misunderstand sukha and attribute to something else. It is your own swarupa sukha. But ajnana is there during, therefore that anubhava that time cannot be, conclusively accepted. Even on waking up, there may be doubts possible because that ajnana is there in all three states. Except in samadhi avastha, this ajnana veiling goes away for a bit. It is not a permanent solution. Definitely, samadhi by itself is not going to give any type of moksha. Nitya. So in this ajnana going away, what is happening is that for a time being, the symptoms are suppressed. The symptoms, like the modern medication, like the allopathy medication, the symptoms are suppressed. The root cause is not resolved. So ajnana, the root disease, continues to be, which crops up as soon as the prarabdha is active. Thereby, whatever was the personality earlier, that comes up, but there is other benefit also. So samadhi is also prescribed. Just because the topic has come up, I mentioned this is outside the current analysis, but then samadhi is also suggested for vasanakshaya, because there is the ananda megha and that counters the vasanas. So even for a jnani matra, where vasanas are troubling and nishtha is not possible, samadhi is recommended. Samadhi practice helps the jnani to hold on to that nishtha, and when he comes out of the samadhi, he is not the same person. Although general rule is that one who goes to samadhi comes out as the same person, what is meant is that an ajnani comes out as an ajnani, a jnani comes out as a jnani. Thereby there is no difference, but there is a huge difference. A continuous practice of samadhi counters vasanas, and thereby one will find that in Vedanta Chintana, in the nishtha also, nididhyasana becomes easy. Most definitely, there is a huge difference, and thereby even Jivan Mukti Viveka suggests that one of the reasons to practice samadhi. There are many reasons nonetheless. Asya samagriya, and we have seen there are various samagris sixfold in each avastha. What are the samagris? Sthanam, hridayam, just like the sapna avastha. Just like the Jagrat and Swapna Avastha have their own sthana. Jagrat Avastha has Chakshuya sthana. In the Swapna Avastha, there is Kantha, and then sthana is Hridaya in Sushupti Avastha. Shakti Dravya Swarupini. Shakti also varies. Jnana Kriyatma Vyavahara Bhavat. Since there is no Jnana or Kriya, Vyavahara, Kriya Rupa Vyavara Jnana, Kevala Jnana Swarupena. Here Jnana is what? This is Vritti Rupa Jnana. Since the Vritti Rupa Jnana, which is there in the Swapna, that is lacking. And Vritti Rupa Jnana in the Jagrat Avastha also, that is lacking. Kriya, which is there in the Jagrat Avastha, is lacking, which is Stula Kriya. And if you have to argue, we can say there is kriya in swapna avastha also, that is sukshma kriya, that is also lacking in the sushupti avastha. Therefore kevala jnana swarupena eva dravyena sattvat dravya shaktir ityuchyate. So the dravya is kevala jnana, so therefore dravya swarupini, that dravya is jnana rupa dravya. Vani pashyanti, so vaikari madhyama and then pashyanti. Stula is called vaikari, where others can hear. Even if you are muttering a little, you know, something, then still someone can say, you know, what are you saying? I hear a little, speak loudly. That is waking state. In the swapna avastha, there is madhyama, where something is, the words are there, one can internally hear, but others cannot hear. Lips may be moving, but the others cannot hear because no sound is coming out at all. Pashyanti is at a deeper level. Pashyanti. So you see pashyanti. You look at what dhatu is this? Drish dhatu. So pashyanti is basically hearing here. It is shabda. Not hearing, but shabda. No one can hear. You cannot hear per se, but you know that there is shabda vritti going on. Something is going on which is at such a subtle level. The mind isn't active, so you cannot cognize. But pashyanti, that is pashyanti, is you are what are. You are not hearing anything really. Vani is what pashyanti is. This is where unknowingly something can be gained in Shushupti Avastha. This is argued in the 9th chapter of Panchadashi, where I'll come back to that example, but those who, you know, follow science or advances in science, or, you know, are impressed with Einstein and such people, if you look at them, they have come up with some discoveries. They call inventions, whatever you accept as inventions or discovery. How they came to a particular conclusion is unknown even to them. They may come back and try to put them together, but then even after a lot of thinking, they are unable to conclude into something. But still, during the night, something happened and they woke up with some idea which was planted, so to say, if you want to say planted by whatever reason. But the source is unknown. It seems mystical, but then I just want to drive home the point as that pashyanti, when we say the mantra drashta, we say Vaidika mantra drashta. So the level of understanding there, when a mantra is heard, why do you say he's a seer? Mantra drashta, why not, you know, shrota, mantra shrota. We don't have mantra shrota. Mantra shrota is not the rishi. The rishi of the mantra is mantra drashta. So you can see the pashyanti there, drigdhatu is there. It's as clear as seeing something, although it is a mantra which is shabda rupa. And there are many people who have anubhava of something which is not clear, but then becomes clear on sleeping. Of course, everything is maybe, you know, can be analyzed, and some may say, no, I don't agree, it is not mystical. The person has worked on it and something worked. Whatever happens, even Bhagavan Vidyaranyacharya says in the 9th chapter of Panchadashi, I do not know. How it happens, I do not know. But he gives an example which will come up again further in the next chapter, and a little later here itself, there will be a sampling of that, as to when the Vedanta Jnana is difficult for a person, then Dhyana Prakriya one can fall back on, Ahangra Upasana Ityadi. But even Vedantic Dhyana is possible without understanding. It may fructify into Jnana itself. How so? By Shravana, which has been done earlier, which has not fructified, it may fructify during Nididhyasana. Nididhyasana is not the reason for Dhyana. Upasana and Dhyana may lead to Aikya Jnana if there is Aikya Shravana earlier. One may not be convinced, but still that conviction may take place in Nididhyasana. How that does that happen? So there is a Purva Paksha there. He says it is impossible. How can there be Nirguna Dhyana? So Bhagavan Vidyaranyacharya says, how can there be Nirguna Jnana? If you accept Nirguna Jnana is possible without objectifying, then Nirguna Dhyana is also equally possible without objectifying. How does it happen? He says, I do not know. He gives an example of a Vaidika Brahmana, a Vatu, who has been trying to gather the recollect the Vaidika mantra, a particular sukta or something he has been chanting through the day, but he is unable to recall some one of these. He is unable to recall. He tries through the day. He is tired now, goes to sleep, but as soon as he wakes up, he is able to chant it without any effort. Does it happen or not? Many of us have anubhava of something which wasn't clear throughout the day, becomes clear the next day morning. As soon as you wake up, what happened, we don't know. At least some of us have experience. Similarly, the vatu who wakes up, he is able to chant. What happened during the night? He says, I do not know. You call it mystical, you explain it, whatever it is. I do not care for that analysis, what exactly happened, but something did happen. I want an option of a possibility that Nirguna Dhyana is also possible. He says, if Vedanta is not working, do not go across Prakriyas. Hold on to Vedanta. Do the Nirguna Dhyana, have Shraddha. Someday, Shravana will click. So that is the detour I took from Pashyanti. But it is an important point to hold on to, as to Nirguna Advaita Shraddha should not be dropped. Even if we do not understand, it will work someday. No questions about it. Have Shastra Shraddha. Bhoga is Ananda. So there is no Stula or Sukshma Bhoga. Bhoga is Ananda. Guna is Tama. Tamo Rupa. Therefore, Ajnana manifests as Tamas. Sanya is Prajnaha of the Abhimani of Shushupti Avastha. Na Jagra Swapne Avasthayoho Shushupti Avastha Asti. We saw this. This is the Vyabhichara of Shushupti Avastha in Jagrat and Swapna Avastha. Atma tu avasthatre sakshitva sushupti avasthatah vilakshana. And Atma is different from the avastha, and the avastha abhimani prajna also. So here sanya prajna is said there. So that is the sushupti avastha viveka. So what I was saying is that different from the avastha, these are used interchangeably. Sanya is prajna for the sushupti avastha abhimani, where he has become one with the avastha. Identification is there. Therefore, the usage is interchangeable. So, where he says that atma tu avasthatre sakshitvat, which is an argument he has given at all the places, he has not said a particular avastha bhinnaha, but he has said avasthatraya bhinnaha, vilakshana. So, the same refrain is used in the all three. And they are interchangeable. So although we say that Abhimani, Atma is Bhinna from the Abhimani, and he has said Atma is Bhinna from the Avastha, they mean the same thing by Lakshana. So Atma tu Avastha Traya Sakshitva, being the Sakshi of all the three states, Atma is Bhinna from the Sushupti Avastha also. So Sushupti Avasthataha, this is Panchami Arthe Tasil, Sushupti Avasthataha Vilakshanaha iti Shushupti Avastha Viveka. So that is the Avastha Traya Viveka. So we spent considerable time there. Okay, there is no Tippana here, continuing. So let's go back to where we were in the Moola. I think we finished the 283 there. Yeah, Sangrahena Atra Atma Vivechanam Kritam. Then 284 to 316 is Mahavakyartha Upadesha Nirupanam. Mahavakya analysis starts here. Why do you need Mahavakya analysis if you already know Atma? This is the question that will come up when one studies other darshanas. Sankhya, Yoga, they also know Atma. Definitely the Purva Mimamsaka knows the Atma as Sharira Bhinna. Otherwise, no karma will be possible, no karma will be followed, no upasana will be followed, because the gati, swarga gati is for that kind of jivatma who is different from the sharira. At least from the stula sharira, one is different, is known. And one may not have a complete justification to say that atma is different from sukshma sharira or Karana Sharira or particular Kosha, as we saw, but still they know that Sharira Bhinna Atma, at least a particular level, they have this Viveka. Now, Yogi says that why Sankhya the Prathama Malla for Vedanta? they say that Atma is Sharira Traya Bhinna, Panchakosha Bhinna, but still Ekaha, Anekaha, and also there is a Supreme Purusha, Vishesha Purusha. So Purusha, Atma, Purusha, they say that Purusha and Pradhana, what we call as Prakriti or Maya, they say that Prakriti or Maya is Pradhana, or what we call as Avidya also, Ajnana also. But in their case, Pradhana is separate and really existent. Prakriti, Maya is separate and really existent, separate from Atma, called as Purusha. Now this Purusha also, Purusha, Purushad Bhinna, and there is a Vishesha Purusha who has no Sanya in Sankhya particularly. There is, in Sankhya also, there is Matabheda as to Seshwara Sankhya and Nireshwara Sankhya, generally accepted as Nireshwara, but still there is Ishwara in Sankhya also, a particular segment of Sankhya. If we say that Sankhya is Nireshwara, even then yogis bring in Ishwara. Yoga is the practice of Sankhya. Separate darshana, but practice. They focus only on practice. We know Ashtanga Yoga. So there, if you have Samadhi Anubhava and you know that Atma is Sharira Bhinna, Sharira Traya Bhinna, Avastha Traya Bhinna, Panchakosha Vilakshana, Satchidananda Swarupa also. Because with Samadhi Anubhava, you do not doubt that I am existent, I am conscious, which is already there in the non-Samadhi Avastha also, Jagrata Avastha. But you also know your Ananda Swarupa. So what is stopping you from being free already? What is stopping you is Jnana isn't there. And what kind of Jnana isn't there? He does have Sankhya. Sankhya itself means Jnana. That is why not this Sankhya, but Sankhya, the term also means Jnana in Gita Shastra. It's a different Sankhya. At least in the second chapter, it is different Sankhya. Sankhya ha. So Jnana Yogis, that's what it means there. Then in the 18th chapter, Sankhya comes up again, but there's a Guna. So Sankhya Gunas are talked about. Their Sankhya means Sankhya Darshana. Kapilaha. Those who follow Kapila Muni. Kapila Muni Shastra. That is Sankhya Shastra, Darshana. But Sankhya by itself also means Jnana. So they have this Jnana. How can you say that Jnana isn't there? Because they know that Atma is Shariratraya Bhinnaha, Avastatraya Bhinnaha, Avastatraya Abhimani Bhinnaha, and then also Satchidananda and Panchakosha Bhinna also. They know that Atma is Satchidananda Swarupa, but that is not enough. They think it is enough. It is not enough because even after Samadhi, even after Sankhya Jnana, one is still limited. Anantyam isn't there. Anantya understanding is there because Brahma is Ananta, Brihi Vriddhau. Without any Visheshana, Vriddhi is infinity, Purnatvam. That Purnatvam isn't there, and Purnatvam is the very definition of Moksha really. Moksha cannot be where it is Apurna Avastha. Apurna Avastha will keep a person wanting, limited, and then limited in desha or kala or vastu will make the person crave more and more towards fulfillment. So that is not moksha. During the samadhi, it may feel like moksha, but how long can a person remain in samadhi? If one person continues in samadhi for some count is there, maybe 21 days or something, as per some source, the body drops off. Okay, the body dropped off. How about the next janma? What about the sanchita karma? It is not burnt by samadhi. Vasanas are burnt does not mean that this karma is burnt. Karma meaning the adrishta which is waiting. That is not burnt for a Purvamimamsaka. That is not burnt for a Sankhya Yogi. Definitely not for a Tarkika. Or even for the Vaisheshika. Tarkika means Nyaya Vaisheshika. So Nyaya Vaisheshika, Purvamimamsaka, Sankhyas and Yogis, all are stuck with Dvaita Bhava. There is another Satchidananda Atma. There are so many Satchidananda Atmas, and there is one special Satchidananda Atma who is Supreme Purusha as per Sankhyas and Yogis. who is called as Ishvara, Prathama Guru. They, yogis call him as Prathama Guru. They do not get moksha because Aikya Jnana is missing. Aikya Jnana is needed, not Jnana. So Jnanena Moksha is what? Aikya Jnanena. Aikya Jnanena Moksha. And that Ekattva has to be complete. Jiva, we have seen this. Jiva Jiva Abheda. Jiveshwara Abheda primarily, but it should also mean that all Jiva and Ishvara Abheda. Not I the Jiva am different from Ishvara, but Jiva Ishvara Abheda. When Jiva Ishvara Abheda and Jiva Abheda will be Siddha. When one is Siddha, the others will also be Siddha. Otherwise, it is not complete understanding. So with that background, Mahavakya Artho Upadesha is needed. Itham Panchakoshebhya Vivichya Atmajnane Api Na Krutakrutyata Siddhi. Even if there is Atmajnana, which is the jnana regarding one's own swarupa being different from Panchakoshas, still Krutakrutyata Na Bhavati. One will still remain limited. Once you come out of Samadhi, something else is there. If one dies in the Samadhi, then another Janma. Maybe better, definitely better, but then still Janma is there. And then not all Vasanas are gone. They will manifest. Kama, Karma, Karma Phala, Samsara continues. Ataha Jiva Brahma Bheda Nishchayaya Punarapi Vichara Kartavya Eva. So Vichara Kartavya. Manana has to be done. Even after Samadhi Anubhava, Manana has to be done. Even after Panchakosha Viveka, Avastatre Viveka, then Shariratraya Viveka, after being convinced, of course, you have to be convinced that I am separate from all this. But still, what about other Atmas who are separate from their own Panchakoshas, their own Shariratrayas, their own Avastatrayas? What about them? Is there another Satchidananda, yet another Satchidananda, and at the Samashti level Satchidananda? Therefore, Punarapi Vichara Kartavyaha Nishchayaya, for the Nishchaya, for ascertaining Abheda between Jiva and Brahma, and not one Jiva, all Jivas and Brahma. But my Swartha is in my Mukti, therefore, at least at my level, I have to inquire into it. And once I know that Jiva is Brahma, then there is no other Jiva, including I myself, separate from Brahma. So there is no other Jiva needed there. It will be Siddha in the Jiva Brahma Aikya itself. Tasmat Shishyasya Krutakrutyata Siddhaye Guru Hu Tasmai Mahavakyartham Evam Upadidesha. So the Guru taught the Mahavakyartha Upadesha. Taught the Mahavakyartha Upadesha itself is teaching. So taught. Evam. In this manner, he taught to the Shishya, who is Adrishti. Adrishti is the Shishya. Panchakosha Vilakshanataya Jnatam Atmanam Brahmabhinnam Vijanihi Iti. He said, now that Atma that you have separated out like the Munja Viveka, which was taught cognitively though, hold on to that kind of you and see who is that you. Panchakosha Vilakshana you, that Atma that you know now, that is Brahma Abhinna. It is non-different from Brahma. Iti Vijani. You know that. So, Kartu Bhuktuscha Atmana Brahma Veda Sambhava Iti Prashnaha. Now, Adrishti says, how can that be so? I am a Karta Bhukta. That kind of Atma, although different from the Panchakosha, still am I not Karta Bhukta? I think I am Karta Bhukta. So, that Karta Bhukta Atma cannot be Akarta Abhukta Brahma. Therefore, Brahma Bheda Asambhava Tayoho. Between that Atma and Brahma, Abheda Asambhava. So, impossibility of non-difference between the two, Aikya between the two. To that question, there is an elaboration of the question. Nanu, Atma Punya Pape Krutva Swarga Naraka Prithviyadi Lokeshu Nana Vidani Sukadukhan Yanubhavati Tasya Brahmana Aikyam Naupapadyeta Iti Chet Atra Uchyate. The answer to that question, which is in details, what is the question really? Atma having done Punya and Papa continues to go to Swarga, Naraka, take avatara everywhere, Prithivi, Ityadi, in various lokas, there is Gati. And then what is the gati for, what is the avatara for, what is the janma for, in whichever sharira. Nana vidhani sukha dukhani anubhavati. Atma has anubhava sukha and dukha, which are of various types. That kind of atma cannot have oneness with Brahma. Therefore, tasya atmanaha sukha dukha bhokta. Sukha dukha bhoktuhu atmanaha Brahmana aikam nau papadyeta. And why is there sukha dukha bhoga? Because punya paape kritva bhokta bhavati atma. So karta bhavati, therefore punya paape kritva bhokta bhavati, sukha dukha bhokta bhavati. Tasya atmanaha Brahmana aikyam na upapadyeta. It is not possible if this, the aikya is not possible with Brahma, who is akarta bhokta. If this is the question, purvokta prashnasya uttaram. What is the uttaram there? Answer given is akartuhu abhoktuhu nitya muktasya atmana sada Brahma veda siddha eva. The guru says that you are still thinking about the karta bhokta, but kartrutva bhoktrutva is at the vijnanamaya kosha and anandamaya kosha respectively. You have already differentiated yourself from that kartrutva bhoktrutvam also. You are not a karta, you are not a bhokta. Why? Because this panchakosha viveka has led you there. So if you have concluded that you are different from the panchakoshas, you cannot be a karta bhokta. How do you claim yourself to be a karta bhokta at all? Vijnanamaya kosha is karta, it has been explained vividly. Anandamaya kosha is the bhokta. Rather, the bhoktrutvam dharma, that dharma of bhoktrutva is at the level of the kosha. Anandamaya kosha. By gradations of ananda. Priyamoda pramoda vrittya. Or vritti bhi. But you have nothing to do with that. You are separate from vilakshana. We have seen that. You are not a karta. Vijnanamaya kosha. The buddhi sambandha makes you a karta, but buddhi is a kosha. You are not the kosha. Separate from that. Therefore, panchakosha vilakshana atma yaha tomasi. That kind of you, tvam karta bhokta na bhavasi. You are not that. How can you claim that I am karta bhokta and that kind of karta bhokta atma cannot be one with Brahma? You are an akarta. Therefore, tasya, tasya kasya, tava. So, tava akartu abhoktuhu nitya muktasya atmanaha. Who is already mukta, that kind of atma. Tasya tava atmanaha sada brahma abhedaha siddha eva. Brahmana saha abhedaha siddha eva. Brahma swarupad atmanaha bhinnataya drishyamanam shastreshu shrutancha punya papa swarga narakadikam sarvam mithya iti vijanihi nahi mithya vastvadishthanam dushayati. So mithya iti vijanihi, everything other than atma, what is that? Brahma swarupad atmanaha bhinnataya, whatever is different from atma, which by swarupa is Brahma, Brahma bhinna sarvam mithya. Therefore atma bhinna sarvam mithya. Thereby drushyamanam shastreshu shrutamcha, whatever you cognize as different from yourself, panchakoshas, and as taught in the shruti, what which you have heard in shravana, punya papa swargadi kam sarvam, not only panchakosha, but panchakosha transaction with anything else. Panchakosha at the individual level, but at the total level, if you analyze, it includes the jagat also. So, punya papa swarga narakadikam sarvam, everything is included there other than atma. Is punya you? No, punya is separate from me. So, panchakosha vilakshana should teach you vilakshanatvam. The panchakosha viveka should teach you viveka from anything that is not atma. Oh, punya is not my kosha, if you say, okay. Have you learnt avasthatraya viveka? Have you learnt viveka from how to differentiate yourself? So you ask yourself, am I punya? No. Am I papa? No. I am definitely not Swarga. I am not Naraka. So therefore, everything can be included in Anatma. Punya papa swargadikam sarvam mithyaiti. Why? Because bhinnataya, atmana bhinnataya, brahma swarupat. Brahma swarupat atmana. From that atma, which is by swarupa brahma, from that there is difference, there is bhinnatat, bhinnatvam in punya papa swarga naraka ityadi sarvam mithyaiti vijanihi. Nahi mithya vastu adishthanam dushayati. And that mithya vastu, punya, papa, swarga, naraka. And what is the, why is punya papa has been brought in swarga naraka adi? Because the shishya has the question regarding that. Karta of punya papa, bhokta of swarga naraka. So kartrutva bhoktrutva is indicated by punya papa. Punya papa shows you kartrutvam and swarga naraka shows you bhoktrutvam. Therefore, punya papa karta, swarga naraka adi bhokta, sarvam mithya. Karta is mithya, bhokta is mithya. Thereby, this punya papa is mithya means that I am not punya papa, meaning I am not punya papa karta. I am not swarga, I am not naraka. I am not swarga naraka bhokta. That is what is meant. That is more meaningful. But even at the literal face value also, if you analyze, all that is different. But if someone says, oh, I don't have a question about I am my being different from Punya Papa, but I am the Karta of them. No, you are not. I don't have an issue by saying that Swarga Naraka are different from me. Yes, they are different. I am the Bhokta. No, you are not. Sarvam Mithya Iti Vijanihi Nahi Mithya Vastu Adhishthanam Dusheti. Then this Punya Papa, which you claim you are doing, they are being done by the Kosha. You drop the Kosha Sambandha, they'll automatically drop. You are doing it because you crave something by association with a limited personality. You want to complete that personality. You cannot complete that personality. You have tried sin anadi janma. You have tried. It is impossible. Therefore, punya papa being done by kosha, claiming that as atma, you are punya papa being done by whichever kosha, vijnanamaya kosha, you claim identification with tadatmya sambandha. You become that and thereby you continue in samsara, drop that. Because mithya vastu adishthanam, adishthanam tvam chaitanyam, chaitanya rupatvam na dushayati. So mithya vastu adishthanam chaitanyam tvam na dushayati. That atma, tvam, so actually it should be tvam na dushayati, second case, so adishthanam tvam na dushayati. Because mithya vastu is the karta. Swapne Bhiksham atan raja na daridro bhavati yatha. So example is given. Raja in the Jagrata Avastha, if he dreams that he is a bhikshuka, bhiksham atan na daridro bhavati. He will never become poor because he was poor in the dream. His swarupa from in Jagrata Avastha perspective, his reality is that he is raja. He will not, you know, you say that even in, not even in a dream, but even in the dream, if the Raja thinks himself as a beggar, the king will not become a beggar. He will not become poor. Na marichikodakena bhumir adrim bhavati. Due to the mirage water, the desert is not wetted. Na mithya sarpena rajus savisha bhavati. The mithya sarpa does not make the rajju poisonous. Atastvam, with these three examples, we land on mithya vastu not tainting the adhishthana. Ataha tvam mithya bhuta sakala shubhashubha karmanam karta api vastuta na karta akartrutva abhoktrutva. So there is a typo here. Akartrutva abhoktrutva adi bodhaka shruti pramana. You are neither the karta nor the bhokta. Vastutaha. Karta of what? Mithya bhuta sakala shubha ashubha. Punya papa karmanam. Karta na bhavasi. And then akartrutva abhoktrutva adi bodhaka shruti pramana. Why so? Because pramana is there. Shruti says so. And we have seen the viveka. It should be anubhava siddha to you. Cognitively you have analyzed yourself. Logically it should be conclusive for you as well. you have done enough manana on not only Mahavakya, but at least on the Panchakosha Viveka, on the first step of Atma and Atma Viveka. This should lead you to Vairagya. Shamadi Shatka Sampatti, and then finally the Shravana will be possible, which is being taught now as Mahavakya Upadesha. Ittham Tavas Swarupam Atyashcharyam Nirupam Cha Bhavati. So what is your Swarupa really? If you ask, what is it? Yes, it is wondrous. Atyashcharyam, there is nothing else to compare, so Nirupam also. Niragata Upama Yasmat Swarupat Tat Swarupam Nirupamam. Your Swarupa is that where no example will fit in 100%. In no case examples fit in 100%, but then still there is no comparative because you are unique. So there is a joke like you are unique just like everyone else. But it's a fact here, just like everyone else, there is no uniqueness there. Uniqueness is uniqueness from the Shariratraya. But that uniqueness is what? It is the only one. So Nirupamam, there is no second to compare with. Therefore, Ittham Tavas Swarupam Atyasharyam, that is the wonder there. Ascharyavat, everything is Ascharyavat, as Kathopanishad says. Asyayam Abhipraya, what is the idea? So it is detailed out in other words. Tava Brahma Bhinne Swarupe Stula Sukshma Sharire Tatphala Janma Marana Swarga Naraka Sukadukhadikam Sarvam Avidya Kalpitam. Avidyaya Kalpitam. So in that Brahma Abhinna you, in that Swarupa of yours which is non-different from Brahma, Stula Sukshma Sharire. Now Stula Sukshma Sharire is Prathama Dvivachana. Brahma Bhinne Swarupe is Saptami Ekavachana. So in that Brahma Abhinna Swarupa of yours, Tava, Stula and Sukshma Shariras are Kalpita. Tatphala, and not only stula sukshma sharire tatphala janma marana swarga naraka sukadukhadikam sarvam avidyaya kalpitam. All these are imagined. So I would have liked a chakara here. If it is not, then it can mean something else also. So we can read in a chakara here. So stula sukshma sharire and tatphala janma marana swarga naraka sukadukhadikam sarvam avidyaya kalpitam. You can say tatphala janma marana sukha sarga naraka sukha dukkhadikancha sarvam avidyaya kalpitam. So sarvam includes that chakara artha there itself. Due to avidya, all this is kalpita in Brahma Bhinna Atma, which is your Swarupa. Tasma jnanat purvam api Atma Brahma Swarupa eva aste. So you are not becoming Brahma. Brahma Veda Brahmaiva Bhavati or Brahma with Brahmaiva Bhavati. Either way, the latter mantra is not found. So Brahma Veda is found. Brahma Veda Brahmaiva Bhavati. One who knows Brahma becomes Brahma. This is the understanding translation. But Bhavati is not becoming there. Asti Eva, it is Satta. Atma Satta is Brahma Satta. Therefore, jnanat purvamapi, even without having jnana, aikya jnana, you are still Brahma Swarupa. Kalatreyapi atmani sharirasya tadharmanam cha sambandho nasti. Even for an ajnani, there is no sambandha with sharira. Really, there is no sambandha. Vastuta sambandho nasti with sharira. So, sharirasya tadharmanam cha atmani sambandho nasti. In your real Brahma Swarupa Atma, there is no sambandha of Sharira and their dharmas. Atma sada nitya mukta eva aste. Atma is ever free. So what does it mean? This means even without jnana you are free. Really, vastuta. But unfortunately, there is binding connection which drags the jiva as though, Atma as though. Atmana Brahmanaschana Kadapi Bhedo Asti. So Atma is ever abheda has always has non-difference with Brahma, meaning Brahma itself is Atma, appears to be limited but never limited. So that is the conclusion of Mahavakya teaching. Jivan Muktasya Nishchaya Vedanta Shravana Phalamcha. What is the phala of that Mahavakya? One becomes Jivan Mukta. So Jivan Muktasya Nishchaya. Why Jivan Mukta? Even an Ajnani Atma is ever non-different from Brahma, never one with Panchakoshas, Avastatraya Abhimani or Chariratraya. That kind of Atma which is one with Brahma, ever free, Nitya Mukta, even in the case of an Ajnani, once one knows that, then Brahma Veda, Brahmaiva Bhavati, there you can say as though becomes, because now there is a cognitive change. The Buddhi is not tuned outward. The Antakarana is not tuned outward anymore. Even if it is tuned outward, the outward and inward Bheda is gone, because the Bheda of outward and inward is not from the boundary line of Atma. It is from the boundary line of the Sharira, which is Mithya. Therefore, the inward-outward division is Mithya. Wherever the focus is, everything is Brahma. By Bada Samana Rikarnam, Sarvam Nasti, Brahma Eva Asti is Atma Asmi. Brahma, Brahmatma Eva Asmi, Sarvam Nasti, Brahma Eva Asti, Atma Eva Asti, and then what is that Asti? Asmi. Therefore, elsewhere it is said as Yatra Yatra Mano Yati Tatra Tatra Samadayaha. Wherever the mind goes, Brahma Sarvatma Bhava is there. Wherever the mind runs, Mithyatva Nishchaya is there. Therefore, Aikya Nishchaya is a fallback, initially with effort, then without effort. So, Jivan Muktasya Nishchayaha. That kind of a person is Jivan Mukta. Tasya Nishchaya, and then Vedanta Shravana Phalam is that itself. And what is the phala? In details, we'll look at in the next part. Huh? Is there a page missing there? No. Okay. Sukham Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namarupi Adishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddher Drukyatva Nirvana Aparam Sarva Vedanta Vedyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadeva Annamattvanyat Iti Menishchita Matihi. Any questions? So I'll see you next part. Namaste.
Namaste. Hari Om. Hari Om.